Okay, so you've already been provided with three videos on how to build a basic Desmos simulation, a projectile motion simulator. So what I'm going to do is show you here how you can jazz that up with images if you like. No extra credit, just makes it look better. So what I'm going to do is I've got a punt simulation here. So I'm going to insert a punter, and then I'm going to insert a football that will fly through the air as the projectile. So to insert an image in Desmos, I've already gone to the web and pulled my images that I want to use. So I'm going to go to this plus sign. I'm going to add an image to this simulation. And it'll pop up a box, with your files. I'm going to choose my punter image, which is right here. When you select an image, it automatically comes into Desmos centered at the origin, and that's the size that it comes out as. So in order to change the size and its location, if you click on the actual white thing that designates this the screenshot, the center point, clicking and dragging allows you to move the kicker. Any of the corner points, clicking and dragging allows you to resize. So I'm going to make my punter, let's make him right about there. We'll just say he's, kicking the ball. We'll make it look like he's kicking it. He's not quite to scale, but it's all right for now. All right, now that's how you get the punter in there. So what I'm going to do now is put in my projectile. And it's very similar, but there's an extra step in doing your projectile. So what I'm going to do is import my image of my football. This is the thing I want to fly. It is way too big. So I'm going to shrink it down till it's small. That's still a little too big, but I'll make it a little smaller. So you can still see it's there a little bit. Now, this thing is centered at the origin, and what I'd really like it to be centered at is on the point here that represents the flight of the ball. So if you look at the dialog underneath the thing for the football, you see how it's got the center here, 0, 0? That says it's centered at the origin. When I move the punter, it changed to center, right? What I want to do is attach the center of that football to this moving point. So I'm going to take this, copy it, and then in the center line, I'm going to replace that stuff with that. Now, when I hit my slider to start the playing, there goes the football. And you see it flies pretty much in the same orientation. By the way, if you want just the football to be there and not the point, all you have to do is turn the point off, and now it's just the football. If I turn the path off, it's just the football flying through the air. Of course, remember, I only wanted this to fly forward, not backward and forward. I've got that going though. One last thing you could do, although I don't really recommend doing it, you can, if you want to, make the thing that's flying spin through the air. And the way you do that is this angle. That's the angle that the picture is like oriented. If you wanted to make it spin, you can sort of change that to something that involves A. So if I change this to say just plain old A, oops, I changed my puncher. That's not what I wanted. Let's fix that. Change that back to zero. I wanted my ball to spin, not my punter. I changed the angle to A, and now you'll see it's slowly spinning as it flies through the air. All right, so to insert an image, you click plus. Image. If you just want to slide it, you can grab it by its center point, drag it to where it needs to go. If you want to make it attached to a point, you copy the point that's flying, place it as its center, and you're good to go.